Good afternoon, Cross Timbers. Today is Friday, February 19th, 2016. This is Texan TV News from Tarleton State University in Stephenville, Texas, and I am Morgan Cavett. Today's top story, in campus news, Sergeant Clell Murray hosted a two-hour safety course last night on what to do if a gunman attacks. The Civilian Response to Active Shooters Events course drew a crowd of about 30 concerned Stephenville citizens and Tarleton State students. Murray went into depth about the best way to protect yourself during an attack and the precautions people can take to avoid injury. Texan TV News spoke with Murray to discuss his experience with active shooter events and the importance of civilians being prepared for those situations.
American public is really not ready for the type of security that we really need to make us safe 100% of the time. But I say you need to have your tool for protection and then tool for treatment, to treat yourself or someone else that's injured. So if you've got a first aid kit, a little basic knowledge on how to stop a major gunshot wound or something like that, that's gonna help you a whole lot more than making a phone call. You know, you still got 3 minutes, you gotta survive before the police can get there once you made that call. Statistics show that over 60% of the events occur in commerce, businesses. And so that's where it's gonna happen. That's where the targets of opportunity are at, in the stores, at the sales. So it's very important that people realize how the police are gonna respond, how the situation is gonna be handled, and plus give people options to survive.
Murray says that business owners should always carry a weapon that they feel comfortable defending themselves with. For more information about how to defend yourself in an active shooter situation, go to www.alert.org. In regional news, Stephenville is getting a new urgent care clinic. The Flash News reports that Dr. Kelly Doggett, the owner of Convenient Care Family Medicine, is partnering with Afford-A-Care to open the new clinic. The facility will be open 7 days a week and feature fast, affordable, and quality walk-in care for non-life-threatening conditions and injuries. Laboratory and x-ray services will also be available on-site, and most insurances, including TRICARE, will be accepted. The state-of-the-art facility will be accepting patients this spring and will be located in the new Shops of Stephenville Strip Mall, also known as the old Coca-Cola building. Dr. Doggett will serve as the medical director at the new 3,440-square-foot Stephenville Clinic, and he says that he is thrilled to offer patient services after hours and on weekends. And now, today's Texas national and international news from the Associated Press. In Texas news, Texas State Trooper Brian Insignia now could face a perjury charge after questions arose about whether he lied in an affidavit about the arrest of Sandra Bland. Insignia states in the affidavit that Bland was combative and uncooperative after he stopped her from making an improper lane change. Video footage of the arrest on the police's dash cam has shown that his allegations of her behavior are possibly not true. The AP reports that last month a grand jury tied its perjury incitement of Insignia to his statement in the affidavit. Sandra Bland was found dead last summer in her jail cell following her arrest during a confrontational traffic stop in Houston. Her death was ruled as a suicide and sparked controversy around the nation. In national news, the AP reports that Pope Francis entered the fire of the presidential campaign when he spoke out about Donald Trump's approach to illegal immigration. While visiting Mexico, Francis prayed where people died trying to cross the U.S.-Mexico border. On the papal plane, reporters asked Francis what he thought of Trump's campaign promise to build a wall. Francis responded, saying, "A person who thinks only about building walls, wherever they may be, and not building bridges is not Christian." Trump responded within minutes, saying it was disgraceful for a religious leader to question a person's faith. Trump says he is proud to be a Christian, and as president, he will not allow Christianity to be constantly attacked and weakened. In international news, the United States is receiving heat from Turkey to cut ties with Kurdish militias after a deadly attack in Ankara on Wednesday. 28 people were killed and dozens were injured after a bomb targeting military personnel exploded in a car. The Turkish prime minister says that a Syrian national with links to Syrian Kurdish militias and a member of the Kurdish Workers' Party carried out the attack together. The United States maintains ties with the Syrian Kurdish militia and provides weapons to the group to combat ISIS. Turkish leaders are pushing the United States to cut those ties because of the group's alliance with PKK, an acknowledged terrorist group in both the U.S. and Turkey. The U.S. has rejected those desires, and Turkey officials have shot back at the rejection. For more state, national, and international news, we turn to the Associated Press for the AP News Minute.
This is AP News Minute. President Obama will make a historic trip to Cuba next month. It will mark the first time in nearly 70 years a sitting U.S. president will visit the communist nation. Obama says he'll raise human rights issues with Cuban President Raul Castro. In Turkey, the government blamed Kurdish militant groups for Wednesday's deadly suicide bombing in Ankara. It's also urging the U.S. to sever ties with a Syrian Kurdish militia that's been a key force in the fight against ISIS. International boxing star and Filipino politician Manny Pacquiao isn't backing away from his opposition to same-sex marriage. The champion boxer lost his Nike sponsorship after denouncing people in gay relationships as worse than animals. Noreen Nasser, Associated Press with AP News Minute.
Today's broadcast was produced by Cassie Stafford, Corey Todd, Sydney Burns, and Alejandra Arreguin. You can follow us on www.texannews.net. Don't forget to tell your friends about us and become a fan of Texan TV News on Facebook. I am Morgan Cavett. Tune in Monday for the latest news from the Tarleton State University campus in Stephenville, Texas.